In this video, we will talk about love. In particular, the love numbers, introduced in 1911 by Augustus Love, an English mathematician mostly known for his work on elasticity. The love numbers are a set of three numbers, h, k, and l. They are dimensionless numbers and describe the elasticity of an object. In fact, they are commonly used to describe the elastic properties of our planet and can help to refine the calculations of satellite orbits. H and K were introduced by Love himself, whereas L was added by the Japanese physicist Tokieda 1 year later. So what kind of elastic properties are we talking about? In order to discuss the Love numbers, we would like to investigate how gravitational forces exerted by other planets, called tidal forces, affect the shape of the Earth. Similar to a multipole expansion in electrodynamics, we can expand the tidal potential that the Moon or other planets create in a series of terms. The first term, n equals 0, in this expansion is a constant. Therefore, if you want to calculate the force by taking the negative derivative, the resulting force is 0. So we can neglect this term. The next term in the potential, with n equals 1, gives us a term linear in the coordinates we use. Therefore, the force will be a constant. In fact, this is the orbital force that keeps our solar system on tracks and does not count towards the tidal forces. So we also neglect this term. The first interesting term concerning tidal forces is the n equals 2 term in the tidal potential. The magnitude of this term is given by gm over r to the third power, where g is Newton's gravitational constant, m is the mass of the attracting object, and r is the distance between the Earth and the attracting object. To compare which objects have the greatest influence on our planet, let's say that the Moon affects the Earth with a strength of 100%. Then the Sun affects us with 46%, Venus with only 0.005%, and Jupiter with just 0.0006%. So in a very good approximation, we can restrict ourselves to the tidal forces from the Moon and the Sun, called lunisolar tides. Okay, back to the love numbers. Let's assume we know the tidal potential to all necessary orders up to n. Then this potential will have the following effects on our planet. The surface of the Earth will be deformed in the vertical, that is a radial direction, according to hn times v over g. Hn is the love number for a potential of order n, v is the tidal potential, and g is the Earth's gravitational acceleration. We will also get a horizontal displacement described via ln times the gradient of v divided by g. Now let's pause for a moment and notice the quantity v over g. This has dimensions of length and can hence be interpreted as the deformation of the planet or as the so-called equilibrium surface if we consider, for instance, an ideal ocean. Therefore, v over g has a special name. It is called the equilibrium potential or potential height. Finally, all this deformation of the Earth's surface gives rise to an additional gravitational potential, described by knv. For a perfectly solid, rigid Earth, all love numbers would be zero. However, since our planet can and does undergo deformations, the love numbers have finite values. If we assume that a quadratic tidal potential is a good enough approximation, then h2 is about 0.6, l2 is about 0.084, and k2 is around 0.3. Remember, since h2 gives us the radial deformation, we deduce that the Earth's surface moves about half a meter up and down in the daily rhythm of the tides. If we use spherical coordinates, we can describe the horizontal deformation more detailed as u theta being equal to ln times the derivative of v with respect to theta divided by g, and u phi is ln times the derivative of v with respect to phi divided by the sine of theta and g. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.